Start it up. I love it. Look at this day. It's gorgeous. My name is Melanie Compton, and I was diagnosed October 28, 2006.
I am making a salmon niçoise salad. I'm Miggy Olson, and I was diagnosed with stage 4 pancreatic cancer on April 5th of 2006.
Come on, Chu, let's go. I'm Ed Oliverty, and I was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer 2.5 years ago.
I started itching about 2 weeks before the diagnosis. Just out of the blue, I had no rash, nothing, but I was itching from head to toe. He called and said, "We've found a tumor in your pancreas, and it appears you have pancreatic cancer. Go home, read about it. You'll need to get some help." And I literally don't really remember anything after that. I was in shock.
My husband he had just walked in the door, and I had just gotten a phone call from my internist, and she sounded very concerned. I just had a CT scan, and I told my husband that I had this mass on my pancreas, and I had to go and get another CT scan, and I'll never forget the look on his face. That was awful. That was like somebody just kicked the wind out of him.
Down here? Well, these are pictures of our group on cruises. I do the lead singing for and a music director for a group called the Stardust Follies. We were looking for something else. We weren't looking for pancreatic cancer. We were looking for gallbladder trouble, because I got sick on a cruise ship while I was doing a musical show. He called 3 or 4 days later and says, "Your gallbladder's fine." I said, "Great, but..." And it's the butt that'll get you every time. In came the word that I had a tumor, a small tumor in its infancy, so to speak. And so I was in shock. I mean, what else can you be?
The hardest part was just going through the treatment and the pain I put my family through. I had the surgery, I had the Whipple procedure, and then I had chemo, and then radiation and chemo combined, and then followed up by chemo.
I had chemo for 3 months. You have constant medical appointments. I mean, you are in and out of the doctor's office, surgeon's office, the oncologist, all the nurses, everybody involved in your treatment. And then for a year and a half, that's your new life, is in and out of the doctor's office.
Dr. Picozzi came to me, I do remember, saying, "It's time we give you a couple of weeks off. Don't want to do that, but it appears to me that you are in need of some time off." I was down to 122 pounds from 185. I wasn't eating. They were feeding me with a tube for 6 weeks. When I saw myself sideways in a mirror at 122 pounds with no hair, I wasn't sure I knew what I was looking at. Sure as shooting wasn't me. Yeah, it threw me for a real loop.
I've got 3 kids, and it was really hard to see them feel like they had to be strong. It's hard to see your family, your kids, your parents, your partners, they in such pain.
It's a tidal wave of emotional turmoil. It just takes over your family and friends. It's a burden on everybody, because I couldn't drive. The chemo had changed my eyesight, and my glasses didn't work anymore. And plus the fact that you don't feel good. You feel really crappy.
the unknown, where it's all going to go, where it's all going to end. You know what you're thinking. You know what you're planning. You know what you're going to do. You know you got plans. You know you got a reason to get up in the morning. But secretly you wonder, will it happen? And it happens that way.
Sometimes I kind of see all these Susan G. Komen things and I'm thinking, gosh, there's so much attention on breast cancer. There needs to be more attention on pancreatic cancer, because if more people were caught sooner, if pancreatic cancer was caught sooner, more people would live. And we need to find the tools to catch it sooner for everybody.
The cost of all my treatment was over $585,000. I understand from PanCAN that 38,000 people last year were diagnosed with pancreatic cancer in the United States. Why aren't we putting as much money as we can into research to prevent it or catch it at a much earlier stage and curing people?
I look at salaries of athletes, $32 million. We're putting a ball through a ring. And yet I look at friends who have tried to survive cancers and other heart problems and things of that nature, begging for money to help us find the ways to save the human being. You can't never tell me that watching a basketball game is more important than living. Number 11, remember that, dear. How lucky can one guy be? I kissed her, she kissed me.
Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head? The room was completely black.
I liken this to a 10-round bout. Me and my opponent. My opponent, Mr. Pancreatic. He whipped the hell out of me for about 6 rounds. In the 7th round, I sucked it up a little bit. 8th round, I got to him. 9th round, I put him on the deck. But just at the count of 9, he got up. Went back to the corner and he came out. Well, this is round number 10. I intend to put him away.
It's just like the fella said, tell me quick, ain't love a kick.
I take one day at a time. That's the gift of cancer, is that you focus on right now. You're here right now. You don't worry about what could happen 2 years down the road. I'm taking more trips, seeing family more, seeing friends more, doing what I enjoy doing. Could be anything. If I get interested in something, I jump on it.
A lot of people, myself included, give lip service to the fact that we appreciate every day and every moment of every day. And you know what, after going through this, I really do. One of the gifts I was given was this plaque, and it said, she believed she could, so she did. And even now when I think about it, I did believe I could, and I did.
She's telling me we'll be with. She's picked out a king-size bed. I couldn't feel any better, or I'd be sick.